Sports. It's in the game.
Welcome to my playthrough of Advanced Family Football 2002 EA Sports. It's in the game! Now get back out there and play, kid. Because the game is more important than for you to sit on the bench. Get back out there!
It's a sport like no other, overflowing with pageantry and a rich tradition that is simply unparalleled. For 60 minutes, there are no limits. All things are achievable and no goal insurmountable. Tradition, to be able to walk in the footsteps of past heroes, to become the victor. Today, heroes will be realized and heartfelt dreams will be dashed. Those who are able to hear the triumphant call of glory. Because every game counts in NCAA football.
Well, guys, you like my little intro there, and plus the game intro as well, but yeah. Every game counts in NCAA Football 2002. Welcome. For this one, I mean, I am going to be as my Ducks, no question about it, playing three games for you. So, and plus the games I choose, so, to actually do. And I'll tell you the reason why. As soon as my game... Okay, there it goes. Okay, just taking its time. Alrighty. So anyway, there's your exhibition, there's season, there's dynasty, practice, there's options, campus challenge, and inside EA Sports. So here's the teams out. As soon as I get... I mean, as soon as I show all of them off here. Alrighty. Okay, we got Air Force, Akron, Alabama, Alabama A&M. Yep, they got the small schools in here. Yeah, that's better. Got Alabama State, Alcorn State, Arizona State, Arkansas State, Arkansas Pine Bluff, Army, Auburn, Ball State, Baylor, Bethune Cookman, I hope I pronounced that right, and Boise State, Boston College, Bowling Green, and Brown, Buffalo, Brigham Young, Cal, Central Michigan, Cincinnati, number 17, Clemson, number 23, Colorado State, Columbia, Cornell, Dartmouth, Delaware State, Duke, Eastern Michigan, Eastern Carolina, number 1, Florida A&M, number 5, Florida State, Fresno State, Georgia, number 11, Georgia Tech, Grambling State, I hope I said that right, Hampton, Harvard, Hawaii, Houston, Howard, Idaho, number 19, Illinois, Indiana, Iowa State, Jackson State, Kansas, number 10, Kansas State, Kent State, Kentucky, Louisiana Tech, Louisville, number 13, Louisiana State, Marshall, Maryland, Memphis, number 2, Miami, Ohio, number 14, Michigan State, Mid-Tennessee State, Minnesota, Miss Valley State, Mississippi State, number 21, and that's Mississippi Valley State, sorry. Then Missouri, Morgan State, Navy, North North Carolina A&T. North Carolina State. Number 7, Nebraska. Nevada. New Mexico. New Mexico State. North Fork State. Sorry, I hope I said that right. North Carolina. North Texas. Northern Illinois. Number 15, Northwestern. Number 24, Notre Dame. Ohio. Ohio State. Number 3, Oklahoma. Oklahoma State. Ole Miss. Number 8, Oregon. Ducks. Number 18, Oregon State. Penn State. Number 25, Pittsburgh. Prairie View A&M. I hope I said that right. Princeton. Number 22, Purdue. Rice. Rutgers. San Diego State. San Jose State. South Carolina State. SMNU. Number 16, South Carolina. Southern Miss. We'll post both guys on MSU. It's Southern. Shoot. It's a school in Texas. Put that way. That's Stanford, Syracuse, TCU, Temple. Number 6, Tennessee. Number 4, Texas. Texas A&M. Texas Southern. Texas Tech. Toledo. Troy State. Tulane. Tulsa. UAB. I think it's University of Alabama, Birmingham. Right? Then UCF. It's the University of Central Florida. Then number 20, UCLA. UConn. University of Louisiana, Lafayette. University of Louisiana. Monroe. Sorry, I was trying that out. It's the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. The University of Southern California. Then the University of South Florida. Utah State. The University of Texas, El Paso. Vanderbilt. Virginia. Number 9, Virginia Tech. Wake Forest. Number 12, Washington. Washington State. West Virginia. Western Michigan. Wisconsin. And Wyoming. And Yale. And then you got your all teams. There's all teams in their name. And then there's your mascots. Virginia Tech mascot. So, which I understand there's others to actually get. So, anyway, here's the fields. I'll just go by them here. There's Falcon Stadium, Rubber Bowl, Bryant, Denny Stadium, Lewis Cruz Stadium, Alabama State Stadium, Spike Stadium, Arizona Stadium, Sun Devils Stadium, Razorback Stadium, Indian Stadium, Golden Lions Stadium. Mechie Stadium, Jordan Hare Stadium, Ball State Stadium, Floyd Casey Stadium, BCC Stadium, Broncos Stadium, the Blue Turf, Alumni Stadium, Dot L. Perry Stadium, I hope I said that right, Browns Stadium, UB Stadium, Cougars Stadium, Memorial Stadium, Kelly Short Stadium. Sorry guys, got a little bug here. Just now. There you go. I didn't realize that was on my TV. Alright, and Nippert Stadium, Clemson Memorial Stadium. Yeah, sorry about my STs. They're kind of bad. Then Folsom Field. I hope I pronounced that right. Then there's Hughes Stadium, Lawrence A. Wynn Stadium. I hope I pronounced this right. Chulukoff Field. I hope I pronounced that right. That one's hard. I should have got another bug. Hold on, guys. Jeez. Thing bug. Memorial Field. Alumni Stadium. Wallace Wade Stadium. Reinerson Stadium. I hope I said that right. Dowdy Fickleson Stadium. Ben Hill Griffin Stadium. Bragg Memorial Stadium. Dale Campbell Stadium. Bulldogs Stadium. Sanford Stadium. Bobby Dodd Stadium. Robinson Stadium. Armstrong Field. Harvard Stadium. Aloha Stadium. Robertson Stadium. William H. Greene Stadium. Kiwi Dome. I've been by that once. Memorial Stadium. Kinnick Stadium. Jack Trent Stadium. Jackson State Stadium. Memorial Stadium. Man, there's a lot of memorials, aren't there? KSU Stadium. Dix Stadium. Commonwealth Stadium. Joe Alette Stadium. Cardinals Stadium. Now it's Papa John's Stadium. Tigers Stadium. Marshall University Stadium. Sorry, guys. Birds Stadium. Liberty Bowl Memorial Stadium. Yeah, see, sorry, guys. Like, Sam, my STs are getting bad. Miami Stadium. Fred C. Wagner Stadium. Michigan Stadium. Spartans Stadium. Sorry, guys. I don't mean to. That looks nothing like the Big House. I mean, hardly. Well, okay, it's probably shadowed, but... Okay, Johnny Red Floyd Stadium. Herbert H. Humphreys. Metro Dome. Now they have an outside field now. Minnesota. Rice Totten Stadium. Scott Field. Furlott Field. Hughes Stadium. Navy Marine Corps Memorial. Aggies Stadium. Carter Finley Stadium. Memorial Stadium. McKay Stadium. University Stadium. Aggie Memorial Stadium. William Pierce Stadium. Ken Memorial Stadium. Well, Kennan. Yeah, Memorial Stadium. Fouts Field. Husky Stadium. Ryan Field. Notre Dame Stadium. Pettin Stadium. Ohio Stadium. Oklahoma Memorial Stadium. Lewis Field. Vaught Hemingway Stadium. I just want to take a look at Oklahoma State's. There's Autzen Stadium, where great teams come to die. Research Stadium. Franklin Field. Beaver Stadium. Pittsburgh Stadium. Blackshear Field. I hope I said that right. Princeton Stadium. Roseate Stadium. Rice Stadium. Rutgers Stadium. Qualcomm Stadium. Spartan State Stadium. Oliver Dodson Bulldogs Stadium. Sorry, guys, I hate it. Gerald J. Ford Stadium. Williams Bryce Stadium. A.W. Mumford Stadium. M.M. Roberts Stadium. Stanford Stadium. Carrier Dome. Amron G. Carter. Sorry, guys, I hate this. Well, you know, Stadium. Veterans Stadium. Maitland Stadium. Durrell K. Royal Stadium. Caulfield. Robertson Agreement. Give me a second. Let me get a drink of water. It'll probably get a little better. Alright, hold on. I think that's what I need. Okay. Stadium. Jones Stadium. Glass Bowl. Richard M. Shurush. Shurushy Field. I hope I pronounced that last name right. Tulane's, well, it's, well, what is it? Superdome. S. Kelly Stadium. Legon Field, I hope I pronounced that right. UCF Stadium. UCLA Stadium, a.k.a. the Rose Bowl. Memorial Stadium. Cajun Field. Malone Stadium. Sam Boyd Stadium. USC Stadium, which is the Coliseum. Well, I mean, LA Coliseum. USF Stadium, which is the home of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I forgot what they called their stadium. Rice Eccles Stadium. Yes, sorry, I hope I pronounced that E1 right. E.L. Romney Stadium. The Sun Bowl. Vanderbilt Stadium. Scott's Stadium, Lane's Stadium, Grove's Stadium, Husky's Stadium, Martin's Stadium, Mountaineer Field, Waldo's Stadium, Camp Randell Stadium, War Memorial Stadium, Yale Bowl, and then I got the Las Vegas Bowl. And that's it. So sorry guys about the S, the stadiums. I don't know why, I just get froze on those. So anyway, we'll start the first game out here. Let me head to Austin, well, you know, where great teams come to die. Put it that way. Here we go. It's going to be a day game. Everything's... Wait a minute. Yeah, we'll put it as a night game. Alright, so anyway. One of Oregon's great victories earlier in the season where they won by two with a field goal against this team, USC. Versus Oregon, so let's hit it. You see, there's their uniforms. Yeah, you can only change it for the home team, so. Alright, let's go. Yeah, sorry guys on my STs. Like I said, they're getting bad. Hopefully next time that won't tap and I won't show off the field, so. Which I am planning not to, so. Yeah, all I need was water a little bit. That kind of calmed me down a little bit. Yeah, so I'll be playing three games here for you, so. Yeah, guys, there is pendants, too, that you get for special teams in, well, those bowl games, too, so. But I'm not too worried about it, so I'll just play the game.
Eugene, Oregon, and Outzen Stadium, the site for this incredible football game. And we don't need to worry about the weather because it is absolutely gorgeous out here for tonight's game between the USC Trojans and the Oregon Ducks. Hi, everybody. Brad Nessler, Lee Corso, and Kirk Herbstreit here to bring you all the action of this football game. The Ducks should win this game as long as they don't make many mistakes, right, Lee?
No question about it, Brad. USC is going to have to play a flawless game on offense if they expect to win this ball game. I don't think they got a chance. Kirk, I don't see them moving the ball much against this superior defense.
Now, I think you're right with this game, Lee, and I'll tell you why. Oregon needs to look no further than their quarterback to figure out what holds this team together. Not only is a great performer on the field, he's just a great all-around guy. The total package, he's earned the respect of his entire team. Brad, that's something you don't see from a lot of quarterbacks nowadays.
Thanks, guys. Looks like we're going to have an action-packed game. So let's get down to the field where they're waiting for the coin toss.
Yep, that's Joey Harrington. And Carson Palmer for USC.
Both teams are lining up for the kickoff. We're just about set to get this one underway. Here's the kick. Number 21 fields it in the end zone. It's first and 10. The Trojans come out in the ace formation. That's a pass. Let's it go. Number 2 hangs on to it. Number 6 with a take down at the 28-yard line. 6-yard pickup. Second and 3. Ball on their own 28. Four-man front by the defense. Number 3 back to throw. He's rolling right.
Throws out of bounds.
Just throws this one away.
Okay, third down.
We got 33 here. USC. Well, out of a jumbo set here.
Oh, I got the first down. Bummer.
Number 16 brings it down at the 37-yard line. They grab 8 yards there. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 37. The Ducks come out in a 4-3. Tackle at the 40. They were pretty much stuffed on that rush.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
Ball on their own 40. Second and 7 coming up here. Defense lines up in a 4-3. Back to pass. He's looking for his man, and that one's falling incomplete, and that one is a little off target.
Yeah, he had a little too much mustard on that one, Brad. He needs a little bit more touch on those passes and let the receivers go get it.
USC sets up in the eye. Number 3 drops the throw, and it's caught.
That's good. He's out of bounds. So, which means they don't get the first down, they'll get the ball. So, thank goodness again, Nance.
Waiting the return.
Score that drive.
Bumps the ball away. Number 15 takes it to 14. Not much of a return on that one, guys.
Well, that's an excellent job of punt coverage there. Getting into position quickly and sealing off any space for him to run. Nice job.
Normally, I like to choose Corso's place, but. And we'll post the page and so which one I can choose, which is kind of better. So,
right. He drops back.
Oh, he had it. How are you? We're supposed to catch that.
It's like he's allowing the defense right now to control him by throwing bad passes under pressure. What he needs to do is make some plays and start controlling the defense instead.
Ball on their own 14, second and 10. Back to throw.
Oh, crud. What? That was incomplete. Oh, that was bad. That was incomplete. Let's see this. Oh, that was incomplete. Oh, man. That wasn't good. I'd love to review that, but I can't. Ah, nuts. Well, that's the part I didn't want to start out with. Yeah, that was an incomplete pass. Casey's arm wasn't moving forward, but oh well. Dang Trojans. That's okay, I'll get it back. No problem.
USC to kick. Number 15 kicks it off. Number 34 fields it at the 13.
In this situation, you've got to trust the quarterback's decision-making.
It's first and 10. USC plays up defensively in a 3-4. Steps back to pass. He's going to try and scramble. He's a long one. Down
ah, nuts.
43. Knocks it away. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
It's second down and 10 to go. Oregon comes out with an eye formation. Number 3 off the fake.
Crap.
Is going to be sacked for a loss. Loss of 7.
That's a bunch of yards to go for a first down there. I just throw the ball down the field. Maybe you'll get lucky.
USC comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. He's going long.
Oh, yeah. Well, he had in his hands there.
Yeah, great play here by the defensive back, locating the ball and going up to bat it away.
Not a good start here. That's all right. Plenty of game left. My defense has been good so far.
The Trojans line up in an eye formation, throws it out there, and it's gone.
Was good. Then I got a first down.
Oh my, that long game gives them a first down, Coach.
A first down and a nice pass play. Knowing you can convert on third and long will open up your offense a little bit more on first and second.
Now they're in field goal range.
See what they do from there.
Number 3 drops back. He's on the run. He's looking deep down the left side. Kurtz has a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
What?
Just
let's take a look at this. Okay, let's take a look here.
And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
Okay, looks like he just did drag his foot in, but gosh. What is the refs giving to the Trojans right now? Man, oh man, there was a one that should have been an incomplete pass, not a dang fumble. And now this. Let's see this. Okay. He's going out of bounds! His right foot touched out of bounds first. Oh god, the refs are paying him off. Or paying the refs off. I don't know. Ugh. This is bull. Oh, give me a break.
And he hits the PAT.
His foot was clearly out of bounds before he caught the ball. So there was two touchdowns that shouldn't have happened. But it did.
Number 15.
Ah.
Number 34 takes from the 10.
A team that can run the ball has the best chance of winning. So I try to establish the run here.
Ball on the 22. It's first and 10. Defense lines up in a 3-4. Missed tackle.
Go, 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 go. Let's keep going.
With a takedown at the 28-yard line. They gained 5 yards there. Second and 4. The Trojans line up in a 4.
Oh, nuts. He was right there, too.
They're stopped for a 5-yard loss.
It's a big down right here. You got to throw in this situation.
Third down and 10 coming up. The Ducks come out with putbacks. Back to pass. He unloads it.
Got it.
Number one.
There we go.
At the 44-yard line.
Needed that.
That was a nice leaping catch.
You know, those passes can be dangerous, too, because the receiver makes himself vulnerable jumping in the air like that.
Almost could have went all the way with that. Just about.
Mix it up a little here. You don't want to be too predictable out there.
Maybe I should listen to Lee more.
Going with a three-man front. He's got the first.
And still going. Man, I was still hitting it.
He picked up a nice gain there before being tackled.
Man, does this kid have some speed? Hello. If you're not excited about playing football, then you should be on the sideline watching.
Pro formation here. Checks off the tackle.
Oh, but not that one.
And he was tackled short of the line of scrimmage.
Well, I'll tell you what, here the offensive line's got to do a better job. It looks like the running back was looking for some protection, and Lee, his lineman didn't provide any.
Hey, Kirk, they did the exact opposite. It was like a Spanish matador letting the bull charge.
Crap.
Incomplete. I think he was feeling a lot of pressure there, guys.
I'll tell you what, he's lucky he got rid of that ball when he did, because they were coming.
Ball on the 32. Oregon comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Back to pass, throws it out there.
Oh, I was right there on it, too. He was right there.
You know, it seems like he's allowing the defense right now to control him by throwing passes under pressure. What he needs to
do dang it, I was moving the ball, too.
Controlling the defense instead.
Number 25 comes in to kick the field goal. He's going to have to get a leg into this one.
That's a leg enough for you. And it is no good. Short. Crap. Okay. Okay, let's see if the Trojans can buy out on this one. Jeez. Like I say, two touchdowns, that shouldn't have happened.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
It's second down and 8. Number 4, alone in the back.
In the first quarter. It's okay. No big deal. I can come back. I just got to try hard.
And we've come to the end of the first quarter with the score, USC 14, Oregon nothing.
I'll come back cheating, Trojans.
Now the teams have switched sides, and we're ready for the start of the second quarter. It's second down and 8 to
I'm
go.
Not saying that because I'm losing. I'm just saying that their two touchdowns was not to say it didn't happen. Because you've seen it. It shouldn't have happened.
He was stopped in his tracks on that one.
Oh, yeah, that's because of the nice pursuit by the defense there.
Ball on their own 36.
We're kind of even on possession. Oh, good. Yeah, problem with that drive.
Right. Good job down at coverage. That's just what they teach you to do.
Ball on the 36-yard line. Fourth down at 6. Number 15, the return man. He gets it away.
number 15 takes it to 28. Number 29 with a takedown at the 27-yard line. And he didn't get anything on that return.
But our coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
The Trojans line up with a three-man front. This one thrown deep over the middle.
No, I almost had it.
Tips it away. I think he was feeling a lot of pressure there.
Well, yeah, it was.
I tell you what. He's lucky he got rid of that ball when he did, because they were coming.
Now he was coming. I seen the guy right coming for me. I had to throw it.
The Trojan line up in a 3-4. Number 3 drops back to pass.
Dang it.
That's a 9-yard loss.
Sometimes I can't see them coming out of the corner of my eye.
Just take the snap and wing it in there.
The Ducks line up in a split back set. Back to pass. He fires left side.
Got it. First down.
What amazing catch. First down.
Boy, Brad, you said it. That is a big-time play there. Spectacular catch and great body control there on the long pass reception.
And here's another look at that pass.
Boy, Brad, what a great throw by the quarterback. I mean, this guy doesn't mess around. He sees his target wide open, gets him the ball quickly. Look at the velocity on that throw.
He was really wide open.
Telling my quarterback in this situation to look at the defense and audible to a better play if he has to.
The Trojan come out of the 34 defense. Back to pass. He's looking for his man.
Got it.
Number 8 makes the catch. Number 59 brings it down at the 43-yard line. How about that pass, Kirk?
You know, guys, one of the things often overlooked in college football is the relationship between a quarterback and his receiver. Here, you can see that these two are definitely on the same page.
My goal is to move the ball downfield, but I don't want to give away my entire game plan.
Defense lines up in a 3-4. Here comes the defense.
Dang it, I was trying to get rid of it, and I couldn't. That's a...
You got a bunch of yards in the game, your players might be a little excited. I'd calm them down right here.
I think I just, stop doing the play actions.
Number 3.
Because they just seem to be... Dang it!
He was able to just knock that one away.
Yeah, great play here by the defensive back, locating the ball and going up to bat it away.
Ball on the 50.
Here's it just seems to have a good momentum. The dang Trojans close it.
Lines up with 6 DBs. Back to throw. He's going long.
Ah, nuts. He didn't get it. Man.
Too much mustard on that.
I'm trying to score, but they just don't want to score, apparently.
And let the receivers go get it.
Man, I hate to be down by 2 touchdowns right now.
19, back deep to return.
I love to score, you know.
Number 38 gets it off.
Oh, that was the end zone.
Ball on their own 21. First and 10.
I need to, like, something to spark me up a little bit. Which those 2 big plays that I did were pretty good, but they just didn't... Not enough momentum.
And he can't make the catch. Well, he was under some heavy pressure there.
Well, I agree there was a lot of pressure, but I think he can hold on to the ball just a little bit longer and deliver it with some confidence.
Ball on the 21-yard line, 2nd and 10. 4-man front by the defense. Number 3, back to pass. He throws it.
Ah, nuts.
At the 30. Look at 9 yards on the play.
Well, it was close, but... Okay, I'm going to try to blitz and see what I can do. I thought I got a first down.
Oregon comes out on 4-3.
They got it. Dang it. I should win a goal line defense. I didn't think about that. Well, they did. They kind of would kill me with the pass anyway, so you never know.
Ball on their own 34. It's 1st and 10.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
2nd and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 35-yard line. Defense lines up in a 4-3. He drops back. He's a long one down the middle.
Dang it. Ah, man, oh man, my defense is not playing good here.
How about your assessment of that long play, Kirk?
Well, Brad, not only only a big pass play, but anytime you can stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running.
Oh, gosh. Is this now the Ducks' game or something? I mean,
the Trojans come out of the ace formation.
No, let's got that one.
And that run got stuck. Yeah, you're right. The defense.
Why is the game going slow all of a sudden? Man, the game's going slow here. I don't know what's going on. Sorry, guys.
Ball on the 40.
It's just like it's a slow motion game.
Defense lines up in a 4-3. Back to pass.
There we go.
It's going to be sacked for a loss. They're backed up 8 yards on that play.
Now it isn't slow. Okay. Third and 23. Let's hold them here.
Oregon comes out in a 4-3. Drop the throw. He fires right.
Wide open. Shoot. Oh, man. Dang. Come on, Ducks. You're no better. Oh, geez. That was a pass play that should have not been prevented. Man, oh, man. This is just not good, guys. This is not a good start-off game. No worries. I'll win some games. No problem.
Yeah, but don't forget the fact that nobody was open. That was good coverage, too. Ball on the 24-yard line. The Trojan come out in the ace formation. Number four takes the pitch. And he's taken down at the 23. Ball in the 23.
It's good pressure on the quarterback. I do not believe in third down curses.
Oregon lines up defensively in a 4-3. Defense is blitzing.
And got him.
He's going to be sacked for a loss. He went down hard there, coach.
He had to put the licking on that poor kid.
It's hard to say he's going to make it, but he might.
Number 15, lined up to the field goal. He's going to need some distance on this one. It's up.
No good. It's short.
You got to go out there and compete.
Okay, I got two timeouts to work with here. Let's see if I can try to get a touchdown before the half ends.
Four men up front. Number three, drops back to back.
Got it.
Time play. Did an excellent job there of getting separation from the defender, and he's able to pull down that pass for quite a few yards.
Number three, back to pass, throws it deep downfield.
Oh, almost had it again. Close.
When you're concerned with the game clock ticking down, you got to go to the air.
Second and 10, ball on the 47-yard line.
Of course, I know that.
Comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Drops back to pass.
Oh, man, shoot. Dang it.
You got to execute in this long yardage situation. Just take the snap and wing it in there.
My guys need to just get more open here.
Oregon goes with the ace set here. Drops back to pass. He scrambled. He unloads it.
Got it.
Down. And he's finally brought down at the 30.
Oh, dang, replay and messed up my hurry up.
You got to go to the air.
Ball on the 30. USC comes out in a 4-3. He drops back. He's looking for his man.
Oh, he had it.
Coach, you made a nice defensive play there.
He sure did. He just stuck his hand out and hit the football. As a player, you got to get out of bounds or get a first down in order to stop the clock. You know in college football, the clock stops when the chains are moved on first downs.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 30. Number 9, alone in the backfield. Number 3, drops to throw. Lets it fly.
I couldn't get anybody.
And he overthrew that one badly.
Whoa, the receiver's fast, but he's not that fast. Bring out the kick team.
No. I'm going to try to get a score.
Oregon lines up for the split backfield. Back to pass. He's going long.
Ah, nuts! We just can't score a touchdown. How many times have I been down there and past the 15 to 30? Like, this is my third time? Ugh! This kills.
And we've reached halftime here. The score at the break, USC 14.
Oh, man, I hope we have to make some second half adjustments. This is ridiculous. Well, at least I'll get the ball second half, so. But, yeah, like, I wish I would have scored there. Like I say, we are always on the move and during the field, but just like we just get down near our touchdown, just like we just don't want to score, period. So hopefully our second half adjustments will get down on here. So.
Number 34 fields it at the 11.
Okay, let's score a touchdown on this guy's drive.
You know what?
Okay, guys, let's score a touchdown on this drive. We need to.
It's first and 10.
Okay, this is a. So they'll be bringing the blitz here. Gosh! He's always there sometimes.
You know, it seems like he's allowing the defense right now to control him by throwing bad passes under pressure. What he needs to do is make some plays and start controlling the defense instead.
He drops back. Let's it go.
Got it that time. There we go.
There, coach.
This is what I'm talking about. I like what this coach is doing here by opening up his playbook. It's going to have the defense calling for mercy soon. In this situation, you got to trust the quarterback's decision making.
Ball in their own 47. First and 10. The Ducks come out of the ace formation, drops back, rifles it over the middle.
Got it. Okay, guys, let's score a touchdown here. We're close to the pass the 30 again.
I think these guys are the difference makers in the game. I'd expect to see the deep routes to keep coming and coming at this defense.
Ball on the 27. It's first and 10. USC lines up defensively at 4-3. Number 43 with a takedown at the 24-yard line. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really nice read.
The Trojan puts four men up front, drops back. Now he's scrambling. He's looking for his man.
Got it. What? Oh, he dropped it. Oh, man, he had it. He had it.
He can't take his eyes off the ball.
Oh, that was a killer. He had it. He had the touchdown. Okay, let's get the first down here. What was I throwing at? Oh, man, oh, man. This is ridiculous. Okay, guys, I'm just going to hit it and just try to get the first down.
It's fourth down and six. Ball on 24.
I know it's a risky call, but, I mean, I can't keep taking field goals here. Got it that time. There we go. Well, that was a risky call, but I had to do it.
Guys, I can't believe what I'm seeing. That was a heck of a play.
Ball on the 12.
Oh, that last touchdown should have happened.
They line up in the jumbo set. Gets a call.
Man, I had a touchdown if he didn't fall on his block there.
Before they brought him down.
You know, it wasn't a huge game, but if they can continue to do that, they'll force the defense to respect that run, and that'll open up the passing game.
The Ducks was split back.
Touchdown.
And they're in. Touchdown.
Finally.
A nice little
touchdown. Jeez. My first one in the third quarter. It's a fight song. Okay, that's okay. I'm down by touchdown. So just keep the momentum going. That's all right.
Oregon lines up
That song is well known, as you all know. All right. Okay, now it's time to put the whooping on these dang Trojans. We'll hold on this drive, we're back in it. That wasn't what I was looking for. There's some guys coming for him, but he made a nice move.
Ball on their own 27. Second and three coming up. The Zellers come out in a 4-3. And it falls incomplete.
That's good.
Yeah, you're right. It's hard to catch an underthrown ball like that. He needs to lead the receiver out there a little bit better.
Ball on their own 27.
Big stop here, boys. Let's do it.
Defense lines up at a 4-3.
Oh, I got it.
At the 31-yard line. And that was a nice run on third down.
That's right. Those big uglies up front did a nice job of paving the way for the ball carrier.
Ball on the 31-yard line.
Well, he had it. I mean, you didn't know what he was going to do with it. Usually on the short plays, I should call blitz. I mean, I'm really. There we go. You did that. Big. That was huge.
Second and
16. Almost at 12. Oh, almost intercepted. Oh, yeah, you did. I'm sure Kirk has.
USC lines up in the A set.
Go. Oh man, shoot! No! Oh, nuts! Dang it, that's not what I needed. Oh, dang, throw down curses! Ay, ay, ay! Oh man, that was not what I needed! Oh, shoot! Well, now down by two touchdowns again. After two third down conversions, I thought I would get it. Nope! After a 3rd-and-4 defense, I thought I would play the passer well, but that didn't work. That did not work at all. I just need another touchdown again. God dang Trojans. Jeez. That's why I want to beat them so bad.
USC to kick number 34 and number 0 back deep to return.
I got time still, so no worries.
Number 34
yet. Man, I thought he was blocked. Where'd he come from?
I like throwing a ball here. It makes the defense think you have to stop the run and throw the pass.
That was terrible. Shouldn't have happened.
Lines up with a split backfield. Drops the throw. He's looking for his man.
There we go. Needed that. Oh, shoot. I went all the way. Well, it was a good play anyways.
Stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running game.
First and 10, ball on the 35. Defense lines up at a 4-3. Number 22 brings it down at the 26-yard line. And he picked up a nice gain there before being tackled.
Man, does this kid have some speed? Hello.
The Ducks come out of the ace formation. He's got the first, and they push him out
to
the 7-yard line.
Oh, nice. Need that.
Face mask on the defense. The fullback needs a little love, too. I give him an opportunity to be a hero right here.
Just what I was thinking. Man, that last penalty, I thought it was a holding call. Touchdown. Okay, I'm still back in it. I'm stumped. I'm back in it still. I'm not out of it yet, guys. It's still a game. I mean, heck, that was one of Oregon's best touchdowns.
And he tacks on the extra point. Oregon ready to kick this one off.
I'm nuts. That's okay. Better take a knee. Okay. It's time to do some good defense here. Nice. That's what we need. Pushing him back. Keep pushing him back. And they lost 4 yards on that.
Ball on their own 17.
Just make sure they don't get another big, you know. But remember, those third downs, they have not been nice to me in this game. Well, for defense-wise, that is. There we go. Held them again. Okay. I am not going to be fooled.
The Trojan line up in an I formation. Number 3 back to throw. He lets it go deep down the middle.
Oh, and nuts. Curse. Third downs. Curse their downs. Ah, yay, yay. Oh, man. That was a big stop. I needed that.
And that's the end of the third quarter. Our score in this one, USC 21, Oregon 14.
Here it goes, crunch time now. My defense really got a hold of them this time for a chance for a W here.
And we're ready for the start of the fourth quarter.
Shoot. That's not what I needed. I guess I should have put more pressure on the quarterback.
USC lines up in the A set. Tango at the 46. He didn't get much on that play at all.
Brad, the defense had that play read and sealed it off from the get-go.
Second and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 46-yard line. The Trojan come out in the ace formation. Back to throw. Throws it deep downfield.
No, oh, thank goodness.
It looks like he overthrew him.
Here we go again. Me don't believe in third down curses. Come on, Ducks.
Ball on the 46. Third and 7 coming up here. Number 4 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. Drops back to that. He passes it.
Get him, get him, get him. There we go. We held him finally. Okay, I gotta get a touchdown on this drive. Even though that the Trojans will have a chance, but just gotta hold them.
Number 15, awaiting the return. He gets it off.
A guy coming,
Number 15, yeah,
that's all right.
He couldn't make anything happen on that run return.
Yeah, well, there wasn't much he could do in a situation like that. There were just too many tacklers around him.
Ball on their own 12, first and 10. The Trojans will come out in a 4-3. And he's tackled at the 25-yard line.
And first down. Good run.
Nice run, and that will be enough for the first down.
Yo, this kid has some sensational moves.
First and 10.
Ducks go. Oh, that's all right.
45 with a takedown at the 26. No gain.
As a coach, you've got to do some different things to keep that defense guessing out there.
These four linebackers.
Oh, no, 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 no. Ah, nuts, you butterfingers. Ah, man. Oh. Oh, no. And they're right field goal range. Well, that probably did it in case I get a turnover. That did it. I should have passed it. There's another catch.
The defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Okay, like I said, in case I get a lucky turnover, but that pretty much did it right there. In case they score. Then it's really over. Well, guys, it was a good game. Well, at least I came back, though. At least I made a decent game. I wish I would have a lead.
Number three, back to throw. He's looking for his man. It falls incomplete.
Threw the ball in the cover. Man, I tell you, he's lucky that defense didn't come away with that one.
All right. Well, they're in field goal range in the... They'll be ahead by 10 anyway, so that, like, they're in a good zone here. Oh, there we go.
And they'll score.
Yep. Shoot. Dang cheating Trojans. God!
Look at that. That's beautiful.
Ugh, I just didn't want to begin this game with a losing from the Ducks. Well, plus the first game I lost. Hopefully I'll get better. No worries. God, those first two touchdowns for the Trojans shouldn't have happened, refs. Sheesh. I'm going to try and make this a decent game, so. On my last playthrough of this, on my old channel, I actually lost the game with Boise State, so that's kind of like a curse teal. Which I did beat the Trojans on my last one.
Conserving the clock is important here.
Well, it's over pretty much, Lee.
Players, use the sidelines.
Oregon goes with the ace set here. Drops back. Now he's scrambling. He throws it. Number 42.
I can't do anything.
In an outstanding play defensively.
Yeah, he timed it perfectly and managed to get a hand in there to deflect the ball away.
Hopefully I'll have a better luck with the next game, so... Much better luck. Got it. I didn't hurry up. How come he didn't do anything? Was he present fast enough? He had it. And dropped it.
Coach's mind, there's no reason for that to ever happen.
No.
He has to make that catch.
Yes, he's right.
USC lines up defensively in a 4-3. He drops back, guns it across the middle.
First got it.
Down. He finally goes down at the 17.
Time is an issue here. As an offense, you've got to be aware of not letting the clock run down too much.
USC comes out in a 3-4. Back to pass. Rifles it right side.
Crap, he had it too.
Knocks it away. He was able to just knock that one away.
He wasn't open at all. It was kind of a guessing game for me.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 17-yard line. Three-man front defensively. Blitzes on. He passes it.
Got it.
He's got it. Touchdown. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass.
This is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
Now I'm going to go in for an offense kick, so wish me luck on that. So.
And he tacks on the extra point. Side kick. Here goes
And they got it. Oh, we would have had it. Oh, well. Okay, defensive time here. I got, well, at least I got three timeouts here, so at least I will try to waste those if they run the ball, that is. So, but if they grab the first down, it's done. Okay, wish me luck on this one, guys. This one's the game right here. For me, that is. And I held him. Okay, here we go. Cross fingers on this, guys. Cross fingers. A minute 44 left. I got to score for order to go in overtime. Just don't fumble it. Okay. That's okay. That's okay.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
Ball on their own 26. First and 10. The Ducks come out with a putback. He drops back. Rifles it over the middle.
Dang it. Shoot.
He brought that one up nicely.
You know, that's just what happens when the ball is just out of reach for an interception. It gets tipped.
Ball on the 26. It's second down and 10 to go.
They're playing the pass defense, and plus, I don't blame them.
Let's it fly.
Got it. Okay, hurry up.
47-yard line.
As a player, you got to get out of bounds or get the first down in order to stop the clock. You know, in college football, the clock is stopped when the chains are moved on first down conversions.
Drops back. He's scrambling. He lets it go deep down the
got it! Okay, I'm moving the ball. Moving the ball.
We knew these receivers were fast and athletic, and they are not disappointing us.
I think these guys are the difference makers.
I'm in a good rhythm here. Good rhythm.
Coming and coming at this defense.
Number 9, lines up as a single back. Number 3, back to throw. Guns it across the middle.
Got it! Woo! Yes! Oh, yes! What a catch! What a catch! Yes! But a minute, but 59 seconds for the Trojans, though. Yes! Now tie it up. Oh my goodness. I say, but the Trojans got 39 seconds to work with, though. So it's not over. Okay, wish me luck on this one, guys. Here we go. This is it.
Oregon lines up defensively at 4-3. And it's caught.
Not going anywhere.
With a takedown at the 19. Ball on their own 19. 4-3 defense.
It's all right.
Ball on their own 26. It's third down and 4 to go. Number 4 is a deep back as they line up in the eyes.
No, he stopped him. He had him. No! Ah, crud. Okay. You had him stopped. Shoot. Wish that would happen. Well, actually, no. Okay, no, I guess not. But still, I would have a little bit of time to work with. Gonna hurry up, we're gonna hurry up. 23 seconds, 20, 20, 19. Timeout. Oh boy.
Second and 2. Ball on the 41-yard line. USC comes out with an eye formation. Number 3 drops to throw. Throws it out there.
No! Oh no! 13 seconds.
Yo, that was a perfectly designed pass play, and they ran it to perfection.
This is the sixth play of this drive.
They won't have enough. 2-1 Overtime. Okay. Okay, I'm choosing defense first because that's the way to go. This is it, guys. First overtime game. What a start to this, which I actually thought would be over. Pass incomplete. Yes!
Yeah, he knew his receiver was covered, but he tried to force it in there anyway. That's way too dangerous. You gotta be smarter than that.
Here we go. Big third down hold here.
Oregon lines up with 5 defensive end. Step back to pass.
And he'll get the field goal. Good. That's what I needed. It's over. Yet though. It's not over yet. I just gotta. What I do is just kind of run the ball.
In this situation, I want my quarterback to be comfortable enough with the offense to be able to audible out of the play we call.
Oregon lines up in a pro set.
That was now.
In this situation, I want my quarterback to be comfortable enough with the offense to be able to audible out of the play we call.
Oregon goes with the ace set here. Here they come.
Big opening there.
Brings it down at the 19-yard line. And that was a nice run. Kirk, that was a good job by that big offensive line.
It really was, Brad. And also a nice read by the ball carrier to find that running lane.
We get 3rd and 3 here. Number 9 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. They'll run the option.
First down.
Got the first. Drop down at the 14-yard line. Good pickup on 3rd down there. That's going to keep the drive alive.
1st and 10, and do it again, my friend. You better kick it here.
Yeah, better.
Ball on the 14.
Well, hold up. Now, I just want to be a little bit closer. I don't feel comfortable with that.
Ball on the 14. It's 1st and 10. Oregon will line up in a jumbo set here. And he's taken down.
Okay, now I'm comfortable with it.
Bring out the kick team.
2nd and 7.
I just want to get right in the middle of the field. And this will do it. I win! What a start. What a comeback. Yeah, Ducks. Ha ha. good way to beat those cheating Trojans. Yeah. Good start off, guys. What a good start off. I thought I was going to lose, but came right back. Yeah. Yeah, Harrington.
You know, it just doesn't get any better than this. Oregon, they know how to win football games. Sure, they should have put this one away a long time ago, and it definitely shouldn't have gone to overtime. But they showed a lot of poise when it came to crunch time, and that's something you can't coach.
And we thank you kindly for participating in NCAA Football 2002. Our final tally in this game, Oregon 31. USC 28. We hope you enjoyed this game as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. So long, everyone.
Wow, what a start off, guys. What a start off to this. I beat my Pac-12 rivals in overtime. Wasn't easy. Got the job done. Yeah.
We're here in Eugene, Oregon, at nearby Willamette River. This is a great day for football, and we're anxious to get this game underway between the Stanford Cardinal and the Oregon Ducks. Welcome, everybody. This is Brad Nessler, along with Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit, here to bring you another game of EA Sports NCAA football. The Cardinal are going out there looking for an upset in this one, and I just can't see that happening.
Oh, yeah, Brad, this one reeks of ugliness. Oregon has a huge advantage in one particular area, the running game. Kirk, look for them to run the ball 40 to 50 times in this game and absolutely demolish and demoralize this defense. Big win in this one.
You're right, Lee. This one won't be much of a contest. Oregon comes into this football game led by their quarterback, and he's such a leader, Brad. Believe me, he won't buy into any of this pregame we're going to blow him out hoopla. He's a focused competitor, and he'll be ready to play.
Thanks, guys. Let's head down to the field. The two teams are lined up for the coin toss.
That's right. Oregon's only loss this season was Stanford, and I want to rewrite history. So, the Cardinal will begin the ball first. Yeah, I'll be saying Cardinal because it's kind of hard for me to say the STs, you know, so.
Oregon lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He kicks it. Number four takes it at the four. Makes a move. First and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. One man downfield. And he's stopped behind the line. No gains. Second down at 10 to go. Oregon brings in the nickel here. He tries to spin, and they make the stop at the 43. A gain of one.
Okay, let's do not believe in the third down curse here.
It's third down and 9 to go. Ball in the 23. Stanford sets up in the eye.
Let's see, the Cardinal was wearing all white, but I couldn't change their away uniform, so. Which I know it kind of sucks, but oh well. And I think they got a first down, too. See. Nope, 4th and 1. Oh, good, held them. I thought they got a first down.
4th and 1. Number 15, back to return it. Pumps it all away. Number 15 takes it to 25. He couldn't make anything happen.
Yeah, well, there wasn't much he could do in a situation like that. There were just too many tacklers around there.
Ball on the 25-yard line. 1st and 10. The Ducks go with the I formation. Blitz is on. Guns it across the middle.
Oh, he had it and dropped it.
I think he was feeling a lot of pressure there, guys.
I'll tell you what. He's lucky he got rid of that ball when he did, because they were coming.
Ball on the 25.
My one guy was coming.
Oregon comes to the line, only one man in the backfield.
First down. And a little bit more.
Knocked out of bounds.
I got one to because Chris would fumble.
It's really hard right now, crap, but how about the offensive line? They have their heads on a swivel, and they're
lifting on the center players.
In this situation, I want my quarterback to be comfortable enough with the offense to be able to audible out of the play we call.
Stanford lines up defensively in a 3-4. Drops back. He unloads it.
Got it. Wait. That's okay. Just a little bit of time.
Yeah, that was a good call. I like that call. I like short passes. They're safe and can lead to some really good yardage.
Ball on the 45.
Usually I do this because I look at my routes.
He's looking for his man.
Got it. First down.
Makes the catch. Brought down at the 43-yard line. That was a nice leaping catch.
You know, those passes can be dangerous too because the receiver makes himself vulnerable jumping in the air like that. There's really not a bad play to call in this situation. As a player, you just have to execute the play that the coach has called.
He's backfield. Oh. Number 92 tackles him for a loss on the play.
Sorry.
And he was tackled short of the line of scrimmage.
Well, I'll tell you what, here the offensive line's got to do a better job. It looks like the running back was looking for some protection, and Lee, his lineman didn't provide it.
Hey, Kirk, they did the exact opposite. It was like a Spanish matador letting the bull charge.
First down.
He's got the first. He's knocked out of bounds. 26. He got a nice pickup on that one.
Hey, you guys, watch out for this kid. A team that can run the ball has the best chance of winning. So I try to establish the run here.
Stanford comes out of 4-3. Drops back to pass. Throws it out there.
Got it. Oh, shoot. That's all right.
They gained 5 yards there.
At least I'm doing a little bit better than the last game.
I spread out the offense and let my quarterback zip the ball in there. You only need a few more yards for a score.
The Cardinals come out of the 34 defense.
First down. That's all I need. Just move the chains.
They picked up decent yardage on that one before they could drag it down.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad little run then. I like running here in this situation. It's a safer play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 14. And they make the stop at the 10-yard line. That's a 3-yard pickup.
And he's injured.
When you're in the red zone, it's harder to spread out the defense because there's not a lot of room. But depending on the play, you can find some holes in the deep.
Side formation here. Drops back to pass. He unloads.
Oh, that's okay. Well, at least I got rid of it. At least I didn't go for a loss.
Was under some heavy pressure there.
Well, I agree there was a lot of pressure, but I think he can hold on to the ball just a little bit longer and deliver it with some confidence.
Oregon sets up in the eye.
Oh, come on. Oh, close.
At the 4, a 5-yard gain.
Nope. I think I just better hit it.
They're crossing the line.
Got it.
Got the first.
Oh, almost touchdown, but I'm close enough. Oh, I did get a touchdown. Okay.
Looks like that defense punched out on that play.
Sometimes you can't tell, but yep, TD, first one. Let's see. Yep, got in. No question. Oh, I hit first. Opening.
Yeah. First and 10. Oregon brings in their nickel package. Steps back to pass. He's rolling right. He passes it, and he can't hang on to it. second and 10. The Ducks bring in the nickel package. Back to throw. Rifles it over the middle.
All right, he's open.
With a catch. And he's taken down at the 44-yard line.
How about that reception, Lee?
A good throw, plus a nice catch, and some good blocking equals to a chunk of yards. That's exactly what you practice all the time, Brad.
They come out of the nickel. Drops back. Number 12 is going to be sacked for a loss.
Good.
That's a 2-yard loss. Ball on the 41-yard line. The Cardinals come out of the ace formation. Number 6 brings it down. He didn't get much on that play at all.
Brad, the defense had that play read and sealed it off from the get-go.
Fifth play of this drive coming up.
And we'll stop.
Oregon lines up the 5 defensive back. He lets it go.
Oh, he got it.
They'll bring him down at the 37. That ball was thrown high.
Yeah, but this receiver knew he could jump up and get it. Great play.
10, ball on the 37. Stanford comes out with an I formation.
Yep, that's and first.
And that'll be the end of the first quarter with our score. Oregon, 7. Stanford, nothing. Now the teams have switched sides and we're ready for the start of the second quarter. It's 1st and 10. Number 34 lines up as a single back. Drop back to pass. Let's it go.
Oh, it's wide open.
Number 5 with a takedown at the 17-yard line. And they get the first down on that completion, Coach.
That was a very nice first down conversion. The key to that play was the fact that the quarterback had plenty of time to look downfield.
Number 18 brings him down at the 16. And the defense is ready for that play.
Boy, you better believe it. That play didn't have a chance.
That's right.
Play of this drive coming up.
You mean nothing.
The Cardinals line up with a split back set. Let's it fly.
Yep, and the plate. Good.
Wait, but you made a nice defensive play there.
He sure did. He just stuck his hand out and hit the football.
Ball on the 16.
Throw down yet again.
They line up with an eye. He drops back. He passes it.
And didn't get it. Good. So held him to a field goal.
He was able to just knock that one away.
Yeah, great play here by the defensive back, locating the ball and going up to bat it away.
Fourth down and 9. Number 17 lines up for the field goal. He gets it up.
Way off. Uh-oh. Oh, you're kidding me. Running the kicker, my butt. That's all right. At least they get a re-kick. But it's okay, they make it. No big deal. I'm ahead still. But yeah, but that running the kicker was bull.
They're going to go for the easy 3 here. The kick is up.
And made that time. Nuts. Jeez.
Stanford lines up for the kickoff. Number 4 and number 34 set to return. He kicks it. Number 34 takes it for the 6. Nowhere to go on that return, Kirk.
Well, Brad, 2 things here. You need to do a good job of blocking up front, but also you need to get the ball and just attack. Don't dance around and let the coverage swarm all over you.
Defense lines up in a 4-3. Number 3 drops back to pass. He's rolling left.
Oh, shit.
It's knocked down. And that was a good defensive play.
Yeah, guys, this is because he's in great position to make the play.
I mix it up a little here. You don't want to be too predictable out there.
One man backfield. They're coming.
No, they're not. That's the first down.
Well, they picked up some good yardage on that one before they could bring him down.
Brad, that was a sensational run right there. This kid is very good. You got to pound it and pound it inside until the defense calls for mercy here.
First and 10.
Like I said, I'd always pick his plays. I always look at the card there. So.
Lines up in a 4-3. Number 22.
So make sure to hang on to the football.
Game of 2.
Because what happened in the last game, it was kind of almost costly.
This is a good time to execute the plays you practiced all week.
Ball on the 31. The Cardinal came out in a 4-3. He drops back. Rifles it over the
middle. Got it, first down, and a little bit more.
Run down at the 48. What a play.
What a solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
My goal is to move the ball downfield, but I don't want to give away my entire game plan.
Oregon lines up in a full set.
And another first down run.
At the 43-yard line, a 10-yard gain.
Is it? Yep.
As a coach, I'm trying to show the defense just enough for them to fight on a similar.
I'm killing them on the run.
It's like a chess match out there.
Stanford comes out of a 4-3.
Oh, shoot.
Number 94 brings him down for a loss.
The defensive line was just too overpowering and didn't give the running back much of a chance there.
This is the seventh play of this drive. Number 9 is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Number 3, back to pass. He throws it.
Got it.
And they finally knock
nice.
It out at the 13. How about your assessment of that long play, Kirk?
Well, Brad, not only a big pass play, but anytime you can stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running game.
Smell the end zone, you know you're right there. Now, smelling it and tasting it are two different things. You've got to be able to taste the end zone because it needs 6 points.
Number 13 brings him down at the 12-yard line.
When you're in the red zone, you're real close, but close is not good enough. You got to come away with a touchdown right here.
High formation here.
I like the defense here.
They want it.
Never mind.
Shoot.
I didn't see that coming.
What I do is throw it right here.
That's
you
right.
You got to give your players a chance to make the play and make the first
That's
down.
Okay. Well, at least I'm in good field goal range here.
Lines up in the deep back. Eye formation. He drops back. He guns it to the right.
Oh, man. He's covered. Shoot.
That one way too far out in front.
You know what, guys? That's what I refer to as a radio ball. You can hear it. You just can't see it. And if the receiver can't see it, then he's not going to catch it.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up.
And it's good.
And it is good.
So now I'm heading back touchdown.
Oregon ready to kick this one off.
That's the old Oregon fight song version. Remember that very well.
Here's the kick. Number 34 fields it in the end zone. Makes a move. Ball on the 14, first and 10.
Charge!
Number 16 with a takedown at the 17. A pickup of about 3. Ball on their own 17. It's second down and 6 to go. Stanford lines up in a goal line set. Number 44 brings it down at the 24. field. They're down less than a yard. Ball 24.
Oh, okay.
Ball on the 24-yard line. They're down and short.
If I can kind of I'll make him get it.
Line up in an I formation.
And I did just that.
They lose 3 yards there.
I think we're better running away.
Fourth and four. Number 15 waiting to return. He punts it. Number 15.
Oh, that's too bad.
He just got shut down.
Yeah, in situations like that, Brad, it's probably best if you just call for a fair catch.
Ball on their own 44.
Which I am trying to figure that out. How to call a fair catch. I will learn. Got it. Oh. I thought it was out of bounds. I guess not.
We knew these receivers were
pretty
athletic, and they are not disappointing us.
I think these guys are the difference makers in the game. I'd expect to see the deep routes to keep coming and coming at this defense.
It's first and 10, ball on 24. Stansford lines up defensively in a 4-3. Throws it out there. Complete.
They'll bring it back. Still going.
9 yards. And he threw that ball in there nicely. Did you see that, Coach?
Yes, I did, Brad. And that was a good pass and a very good game.
The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Number 94.
It's okay.
The takedown at the 7-yard line. Yard gain of the play.
I just let the players go out there and have some fun here.
The Ducks come out of the ace formation.
Well, that's a touchdown. Nailed it.
It
was excellent blocking here and a nice job of the ball carrier to get in there for the touchdown.
Here's another look.
I almost got stopped, but I mean, like I said, you gotta hit the pine line to get six. And it won me on the corner, so. Yeah, I seen that. Beware of dog and crossed out said duck. I don't remember that. It was probably during the robbery with Washington.
And he hits the PAT.
Well, I got a 2-touchdown lead now.
Oregon to kick this one off. Number 4 and number 0 need to return. Number 25 kicks it off. Number 4 builds it into 3.
Not off those tackles.
Field at all there.
You know, Brad, he looked kind of confused. Like he didn't know where he was going from the start.
It's first and 10.
Nope. One player's out for Stanford.
Stanford comes out with an I formation. Breaks the tackle. Brought down.
It's all right.
32. Ball on the 32-yard line. First and 10.
Because they have to throw it for her to get a touchdown or field goal.
Nickel defense. Back to pass. Punts once. He passes it.
All right, it was wide open.
Sends that one. And he's finally shot.
Oh, thank goodness for that. He would have scored.
Nearly overthrown.
Boy, the receiver makes a great play by putting his hands up. He had enough vertical leap to get his hands on it.
It just, I mean, it's just like he reached for his foot and he tripped him.
Ball on the 44. The Cardinals line up in a split back set. He drops back. He rifles it to the left.
Intercepted. First one. It could be a pick six. It might be. It's going to be. Pick six Ducks. Ha ha. I was trying to leap it in. That's all right. How about that? Oh, now I'm making a 3-touchdown game. That'll be mine, and see you later. What a great way to end the second half on a good note.
Folks, let's pause now as we've reached the end of the first half. Our score at halftime, Oregon 24, Stanford 3.
Can't wait for the fight song, man.
Stanford will be kicking off to start the second half. Number 17 kicks it off. Number 34 fields it at the 7. Breaks one.
But not that one.
Take what the defense gives you here.
Ball on the 21. Fourth three defense. Steps back to pass. Rolling out to the right side.
Oh, crap.
And that one's falling in.
He wasn't there for it.
As a coach, I'm trying to show the defense just enough for them to bite on a similar play later on. It's like a chess match out there.
Number 9, alone in the backfield. Steps back to pass. Across the middle.
Got it.
Number 43.
It's down.
Brings him down at the 43-yard line.
Yeah.
And a nice pickup through the air.
I'll tell you what, fellas, I love this kid's throwing ability. He's got a quick release and he's very accurate.
As a coach, I'm trying to show the defense just enough for them to fight on a similar play later on. It's like a chess match out there.
I was going to say, so how is the Cardinals' pass defense?
Here they come.
Oh, crud.
They'll wrestle him down to the backfield.
Ran the wrong way.
You know what? This is a good time to execute the plays you practiced all week.
Ball on the 39. Stanford comes out on a 4-3. Back to pass.
Oh, crud. I didn't see him coming. I was watching my route, sir.
That's a bunch of yards to go for a first down there. I just throw the ball down the field. Maybe you'll get lucky.
Third and long. Ball on the 33.
That's okay. No big deal. I'm ahead by 3 touchdowns, so.
Drops to throw. Fires a bullet over the middle.
Oh, incomplete. That's okay.
Sent away. I think he was feeling a lot of pressure there, guys.
I'll tell you what. He's lucky he got rid of that ball when he did, because they were coming.
Number 6. Back deep to return. Number 38 gets it off. Number 6 takes it at the 20. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line. That was a nice little punt return there.
Well, Brad, that was a combination of a couple things. Some good blocks, but also the ability to avoid the coverage team by the return man.
First and 10. Stanford comes out with an eye formation. Drop back. He throws it, and it's caught. At the 35-yard line. A gain of one. It's second down and 8. Oregon lines up with 5 defensive backs. Drops back to pass. He's looking for his man.
He won't get to it.
And it's incomplete. Third down, 8 to go. Ball on their own 35. The Cardinals 23. Comes away with a sack.
And we stopped him again.
Ball on their own 35. Number 15, the return man. Number 39 gets it off. Number 15 takes it at the 23. Number 31 with a takedown at the 44. He made some nice moves on that return.
Yeah, but too many, Brad. Boy, he'd love to have another chance at that one. The field is wide open for a score.
Ball on the 44-yard line. It's first and 10. Oregon sets up in the eye.
Oh, I had opening there. That's okay.
Carry that one for a few yards. You know, when you have a guy like that who can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure keeps some pressure off the passing game.
You got to take what the defense gives you here.
Ball on the 50. Second and 3 coming up. The Cardinal line up in a 3-4. There's a missed tackle. First down.
Good. So we've got the first down.
45. 5 yards.
Got the first time, but I broke it.
My goal is to move the ball downfield, but I don't want to give away my entire game plan.
Ball on the 45. First and 10. The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Back to pass.
Oh, shoot.
The ball's incomplete in an outstanding play defensively.
Yeah, he timed it perfectly and managed to get a hand in there to deflect the ball away.
Second and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Oregon goes with the ace set here. So he got a few yards on that carry.
You know what, guys? If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Ball on the 41-yard line. The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Number 3, back to throw. This one's thrown deep over the middle.
Oh, he had it and he dropped it. Shoot.
That one should have been caught.
Oh, man, that really irritates a quarterback. He did his job.
That's all right.
He put the ball there, and the receiver blew it by dropping it.
Number 6, back to return it.
This game happens.
He punts it.
That'll be a touchback. That's game. My defense has been pretty good so far, so...
Only
hold them to 3 points. It's better than 28.
The Cardinal set up in the gun. Back to the pass. Guns it across the middle. Number 83 hangs on to it. 6-yard pickup. It's second down and 3 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. The Ducks line up in a nickelback. Let's it go. And it's incomplete. And he often threw that one badly.
Whoa. The receiver's fast. But he's not that fast.
Ball on their own 27. Third down and 3 coming up. Stanford comes out with an eye formation. Number 43.
I think he was short.
Just about 3 yards there.
Inches, yep. And pulling away.
Fourth and inches coming up here. Ball on the 30-yard line.
I'm surprised they won't try to fake it. But they probably know they're out of it.
Number 15, waiting to return. Number 39 gets it off.
Nice kick.
Number 15 fields it to 29. And they make the stop at the 32-yard line. And he didn't get anything on that return.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
The Cardinals come out in a 4-3. Drops to throw. Fires.
Got it.
Across the middle.
First down.
51 with a takedown at the 47-yard line. First down. What a pass.
Boy, that was a big-time throw by the quarterback. He did a good job of taking what the defense gives him.
I'm telling my quarterback in this situation to look at the defense and audible to a better play if he has to.
Oregon lines up in the ace set. Number 45 brings him down at the 47-yard line. Nothing going on that one.
As a coach, you love mismatches. In this case, if the slot guy is covered by the linebacker, you may have a nice play.
Oregon goes with the ace set here. Number three drops back. Rifles it over the middle.
He dropped it. Shoot.
Oh, he had that one, guys.
Yeah, that guy will make that catch 9 out of 10 times, I guarantee.
Yes.
It's a big down right here. You got to throw in this situation.
Now it's 3rd and 9 coming up. Ball in the 47. Number 9 is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Back to pass. He scrambled. He lets it go deep down the middle.
Got it.
Number 15 has it.
And almost. Close to the goal line.
What an amazing catch. First down.
Boy, Brad, you said it. That is a big-time play there. Spectacular catch and great body control there on the long pass reception.
And that'll bring this quarter to an end. Folks, we played 3, and our score is Oregon 24, Stanford 3.
Bound to be.
They switch sides, and these teams are all set to start the fourth and final quarter.
Bound to be 31 if we'll if I can get in.
They put everyone up on the line. And he's taken down at the 4. They get a yard on the play.
I tell my halfback to go out there and get a 6.
Oh, he got injured. I didn't know that.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage. And they make the stop at the 3-yard line. 1 yard on the play.
This is fun right here, guys. It's just us versus them. And the team with more will and determination and drive is going to come out on top.
They're crowding the line. They'll bring it down.
Oh, man.
2 yard line. Just a yard there.
Let's just try to punch it in.
They put everyone up on the line.
And touchdown.
And so they punch it in on the ground.
Hardly I don't kick a field goal when I pass the 5-yard line. Oh, the 3.
Here's another look at that fantastic run.
But they have no chance. This one's pretty much over. What'd you say?
Oregon is ready to kick it away. Number 4 and number 0 back to return. He kicks it. Number 34 fields it in the end zone. Ball on their own 16. Stanford comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Drop back on the pass. Throws it out there. And it's knocked down. Well, he was under some heavy pressure there.
Well, I agree there was a lot of pressure, but I think he can hold on to the ball just a little bit longer and deliver it with some confidence.
Second and 10. The Ducks line up with a nickel pass. Number 12, back to pass. Fires deep down the right side.
We got it.
24, makes the catch. That ball was thrown high.
Yeah, but this receiver knew he could jump up and get it. Great play.
He couldn't hang on to that one, guys.
Well, I can't blame him for dropping that, but did you see how hard that ball was thrown? Wow.
Ball on the 47-yard line. 2nd and 10. Stanford sets up in the eye, lets it fly, and it's incomplete. The Ducks line up with six defensive backs. He lets it go. Number 16, pats it down. Guys, he threw that one right into the coverage.
Kurt, nothing gets a coach more fired up than to throw a ball at the coverage. Oh, wait, you never made mistakes like that, did you?
No, of course not. Fourth and 10 coming up.
Nailed him again.
Number 15, back deep to return. He gets it away. Number 15 takes it at the 20. Number 31 brings it down at the 32. He made some nice moves on that return.
Yeah, but too many, Brad. Boy, he'd love to have another chance at that one. The field is wide open for a score.
The Ducks line up in an I formation. Number 7 with a takedown at the 46. Steve Pittman, a nice gain there before being tackled.
Man, does this kid have some speed? Hello.
Might go down.
What I would do here is to give the fullback the ball and just let him, boom, straight up the gut.
The Ducks go with the I formation. And he's tackled at the 48. Gain of one.
I keep pounding away here. No need to go to the air and risk turning the ball over.
High formation here. First one. Number 45 brings it down at the 50. Well, he worked hard for those yards, Coach.
Yeah, Brad, this kid is a hard-nosed player. He gives that kind of effort every single play.
Number 9 lines up in a deep back, high formation. And he's hammered down. 1 yard gain on the play. Ball right around midfield. Number 6, the return man. Number 38 gets it off.
Touchback.
The Ducks bring in their dime package. Back to pass. He's looking for his man, and that one's falling incomplete. Kirby just let that one get away from him.
Yeah, and you can see he wants that one back. That's a throw this guy can make in his sleep.
Second and 10. The defense lines up with 6 DBs. He runs the match. Number 12 is going to be sacked for a loss.
They're coming for him.
And back up 3 yards on that play. Ball on their own 17. Number 12 drops back. He's scrambling.
Throws it away.
Ball on the 17.
This was a score should have been in the real game.
Number 15, back to return it. He gets it away. Number 15, fields it at the 38. He couldn't make anything happen on that rough return.
Yeah, well, there wasn't much he could do in a situation like that. There were just too many tacklers around him.
It's first and 10, ball on the 38. Oregon lines up in a goal line set. Number 92 with a takedown at the 42-yard line. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really nice read.
You got to protect the football here. Nothing fancy, just hard-nosed running.
Oregon comes out with an I formation. Number number 38 brings him down at the 43. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
I'd run the ball straight up the middle on this one.
Third and four, ball on their own 43. Oregon sets up in the eye.
That's a first.
51 with a takedown at the 47-yard line.
Oh, let's just hit it.
Ball the 47. It is fourth down and inches.
It's fourth down inches. I'll just go for it.
They're grabbing that line of scrimmage. He's got the
hook. I got it.
And he's taken down at the 49. He almost didn't make it.
Yo, he got just enough for the first down.
That's right.
You know, there's nothing I hate more than seeing teams run up the score.
First and 10. Four-man front by the defense.
Yep, this will do it. What a whomping.
This one's in the books, folks. Dirk, what'd you think of this one?
We got exactly what we expected to get in this one. Stanford came out as severe underdogs, and they were absolutely demolished by a much stronger, faster, and experienced football team.
Folks, that's going to do it for this edition of NCAA Football 2002. We hope you join us again. Again, our final score, Oregon 31, Stanford 3. So for Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye, everybody, and thanks for tuning in.
Now, Oregon won this game. And then they won later on in the career and took down Miami for the national title. Which I wish that would have really happened during that year. But it just wasn't meant to be.
Carved from the desert lands of Tempe between two mountain buttes, this is Sun Devil Stadium, the site for what should be a fantastic college football game. And the weather is absolutely gorgeous for today's game between the Oregon Ducks and the Buffaloes of Colorado. Welcome, everyone. Brad Nessler here for EA Sports with my co-host Kirk Herbstreit and the coach, Lee Corso. We hope you're as excited as we are for this one. The Buffaloes are going to have a tough time in this one. What do you think, Lee?
Well, I think you're absolutely right, Brad. Colorado does not have a pass rush or the secondary to keep up with this offense. Kirk, they're going to get picked apart like a turkey on Thanksgiving.
I think you're right with this one, Lee. Oregon will be led in this game by their fearless quarterback. I'm very impressed with the competitive spirit of this guy. Brad, when you watch this guy play, you're going to see him give 100% every single down. And it won't matter if his team is up by 30 or down by 30. He's a winner, and he'll get it done.
Thanks, guys. Looks like we're going to have an action-packed game. So let's get down to the field where they're waiting for the coin toss.
That's right, the Fiesta Bowl. Held here at Tempe, Arizona, which I didn't have the actual bowl, but it was held right here, so... So why not? Even though it's got Colorado's logos on the field, but hey, big deal. So let's just play. Because Colorado was wearing their home uniforms as Oregon was wearing their away ones. So be real. And plus, as you all remember in this game, Colorado got destroyed by the Ducks in this one. So hopefully I'll try to do the same.
Because of the penetration the defense was able to get. It's tough to get any yards offensively when that happens.
Second and 10, ball on their own 20. They'll bring in their dime package. Drops the throw. He's looking for his man.
Oh, we got it.
Oh, get him. 16 with a takedown at midfield. How about your assessment of that long play, Kirk?
Well, Brad, not only a big pass play, but anytime you can stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running game.
First and 10, ball on the 50.
Right at midfield.
Colorado goes with the ace set here. Little two, number 97 brings him down for a loss. No gain.
Okay, first time he said a loss, but then said no gain. I don't get it. Oh, a little bit, just by inches for a loss.
Colorado flies up for the shotgun set.
Hit him. He's got all the time. Oh, man.
He'll be sacked for a loss. Loss of two.
Clyde didn't throw it. He had all the time in the world there.
Ball on the 47. Number one lines up in the shotgun. Back to pass. Throws it out there.
Oh, he dropped it. Thank goodness. He was open. And burned away.
Ball of their own 47. Number 15, back to return it. He punts it. Number 15, fielded at the 9. He couldn't make anything happen on that punt return.
Yeah, well, there wasn't much he could do in a situation like that. There were just too many tacklers around him.
It's first and 10, ball on the 9-yard line. The Ducks go with the out of formation. Number 6 brings him down at the 9-yard line. Didn't get anything.
I'm telling my quarterback in this situation to look at the defense and audible to a better play if he has to.
Ball on the 9-yard line. Second and 9. The Buffalo use a 4-man throw here. Drops back. Rifles it over the middle.
Got it.
And they make the stop.
First down.
What do you think of that one, Mr. Corso?
Well, I'm going to say that was a nice catch. He got a bunch of yards there, and that's going to spread this defense out a little. There's really not a bad play to call in this situation. As a player, you just have to execute the play that the coach has called.
The Buffalo took 4 men up front, back to throw.
He's got it.
The first, number 26.
I come went all the way there.
26. Nice gain on the play.
The ball was thrown perfectly. Good precision there. As a coach, I'm trying to show the defense just enough for them to fight on a similar play later on. It's like a chess match out there.
Number 9 flies over the deep back. Eye formation. Drops back. Heaves a long one down the middle.
Oh, he had it. He dropped it.
And he just let that one slip out of his hand.
Oh, he can't take his eyes off the ball. It looks like that's what happened.
Ball on the 46. So it's 2nd and 10. Colorado comes out in a 4-3. Steps back to pass. Now he's scrambling. He's looking for his man.
Got it.
Number 56.
So he redeemed himself.
It's
not the two.
Receivers were fast and athletic, and they are not disappointing us.
I think these guys are the difference makers in the game. I'd expect to see the deep routes to keep coming and coming at this defense.
They put everyone up on the line. He's going to lose yards on this
not
one.
Not close there yet. Hold on, I'm the two.
I just lost my inches. The defense is all bunched up there. You just got to find the defense's weakness.
They're crossing the line.
Touchdown.
Down, Ducks. And so they punch it in on the ground. Kirk Herbstreit, great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
Could this be another blowout? Because remember last game we scored first and we won the game. So.
And he tacks on the extra point.
Hey, we're working fight song. Sheesh. Talk about bias.
Number 5 fields it in the end zone. 17. The Ducks line up with six defensive backs.
Oh, yeah, fine opening there.
The 29-yard line, 9-yard pickup. It's second and inches, ball on the 29-yard line. Colorado sets up in the eye. Gets a toss.
And they got him down for loss. Big loss.
Loss on the play. It's third down and five to go. Ball on their own 23. Colorado comes out with an I formation. Number 27 gets a pitch. Number 29 brings him down for a loss. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Yep, held him again.
Ball on their own 23.
This just be like the Cardinal game.
Number 15, awaiting
the... Or the real game.
Number 8 gets it off.
Cassie Colorado, you are no match for Oregon. Zip. Nada.
Number 15, builds it to 31. Breaks one. And down he goes at the 40-yard line. Just couldn't break free on that one.
Well, Brad, he didn't have a lot of open field to run, but he did a nice job of making something out of nothing.
Ball on their own 40. Defense lines up at a 4-3. They're bringing it. Let's it go.
No, they're not.
Number 8.
Nice catch. He held on to it.
At the 42. And they get the first down on that completion, Coach.
That was a very nice first down conversion. The key to that play was the fact that the quarterback had plenty of time to look downfield.
Ball on the 42-yard line. Four-man front by the defense. Gets the call. Stop behind the line. Drop back a yard.
That's all right. It's in the first.
And we've come to the end of the first quarter with the score, Oregon 7, Colorado nothing. We are ready to start quarter number 2.
If you're not excited about playing football, then you should be on the sideline watching.
He's right.
Defense lines up in a 4-3. Number 3, back to throw. He lets it go.
Oh.
Number 26.
He had his hands on it.
Away. He just let that one slip out of his hand.
Oh, he can't take his eyes off the ball. It looks like that's what happened.
Ball on the 43-yard line. Oregon comes to the line. Only one man in the backfield. Back to pass. He guns it to the right.
Oh, he had and he dropped it. He had the first down.
Really hurts,
guys. Yeah, that's a tough break.
That's all right.
You just can't drop passes, especially on third down.
Yeah, it's okay.
Number 5, back deep to return. He gets it away.
Hey, it's right near the 10. That's good.
The 12.
Oh, 12. Got it. That's all right.
Down at the 18-yard line. 7-yard play. Second and 2.
Yes,
ball
guys.
The
sorry about the back of me.
Colorado
if you can
the
hear
shotgun.
It.
There's the play fake. Rolling out
nope.
To the right side.
To be set.
That's a 6-yard loss. The Buffaloes come out in the ace formation. He throws it out there.
Oh, he got it. First down.
They can
run a coverage, too.
And long, guys.
Well, the offense coming through in a big way that time. How about the timing on that route, Coach? Yeah, Kirk, the quarterback was able to throw to a spot, and the receiver was there to catch it for a first and 10. Nice play.
It's first and 10. Buffalo line up in an I formation.
Oh, I got it. Out of bounds.
And he threw that ball in there nicely. Did you see that, Coach?
Yes, I did, Brad. And that was a good pass and a very good game.
It's first and 10, ball on the 43.
Remember last game, the Cardinal was moving the ball, then they just got a field goal, so.
Number 22 brings him down at the 48. So he picked up a few yards before they brought him down.
You know, it wasn't a huge gain, but if they can continue to do that, they'll force the defense to respect that run, and that'll open up the passing game.
Second and 4, ball on the 48. One man backfield. Number one, on play action.
Get him.
Number one is going to be sacked for a loss.
He had all the time there.
3 yards there.
Caught it, first down.
With a catch. He got up in the air and made the catch.
Well, that's all about timing, too, because if he jumped too early, he wouldn't have been able to catch that ball.
Ball on the 42. It's first and 10. The Ducks bring in their dime back in. They'll run the option. Pitches back. Number 17.
Number 17 was ready for that one.
Decent yardage on that one before they could drag him down.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad little run there.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 38. One man backfield. Nothing doing. Tackle for a loss on the play.
Didn't get a chance, do you think? Okay, third downs have not been nice to me here, so.
Ball on the 39, third and 6.
Third and 7, actually.
The Ducks line up with six.
Okay, it's a jump catch for that. And it didn't get it. I mean, well, heist. Well, you know. Where are they? Down 39? Oh, yeah. They're going to punt it.
Fourth down and 6 yards to go. Ball on the 39. They line up to punt this one away.
Can they fake it? Nope.
Punts the ball away.
Let it go.
I just let the players go out there and have some fun here.
It's a minute 42 left, so halftime. So hopefully, so let's see if I get some points on the board here. Oh, he was caught. Shoot. Two players were on him.
You gotta go out there and compete. Be a competitor.
Ball on their own 21. The Buffalo come out of the
well, plus I got three timeouts to work with. Ah, oh, he dropped it again.
I'd come out going here. You know you got a ways to go for the first. So I just approach it like any other play.
It's third down at 10. The defense lines up with 6 DBs. Back to pass. Let's it fly.
Got it.
Got the first. They'll bring him down at the 47-yard line.
He did that.
Here's a good opportunity to see who your playmakers are.
Ball on their own 47. They use 4 linebackers. He's going to try and scramble. Let's it go.
Got it.
Number 84.
And he's gone. He's gone. Touchdown, Ducks. Nice.
And they got burned deep on that one, my friend.
I'll tell you what, my friend. That quarterback has a killer instinct. He saw a hole in the defense and immediately he attacked
it. Well, plus that broke the tackle right there. Yep. He was gone.
Yeah. takes the PAT. Oregon ready to kick this one off. Number 5 and number 0 back ready to return. Here's the kick. Number 14 fields it in the end zone.
Nope. It's all right. At least didn't break 2 tackles.
It's 1st and 10, ball on their own 26. They'll bring in their dimes package. At the 26-yard. Back to pass. He throws it incomplete.
Oh, he almost had it.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 26. Drops back to pass. Throws it out there.
Got it.
Number 88. Hangs on to it.
Ah, nuts. Oh, good. Glad they got him. Glad they got him right there, or he would have scored.
The Buffalo set up in the gun, rifles it right side.
I got it.
And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Along the 26-yard line. Colorado lines up with a shotgun set. He drops back, fires a bullet over the middle. That one way too far out in front.
You know what, guys? That's what I refer to as a radio ball. You can hear it, you just can't see it. And if the receiver can't see it, then he's not going to catch it.
Number 1 steps back to pass. Let's it go. Number
I got
2
it.
Has it. Number 22 brings him down at the 12-yard line. What a catch, and that's going to give him a first down.
Well, that's a big play for the offense, but I think the defense needs to play a little bit tighter in the secondary.
1st and 10, ball on the 12-yard line. Number 1, back to throw. Throws it out there.
Oh, he had it.
Well, he was under some heavy pressure there.
Well, I agree there was a lot of pressure, but I think he can hold on to the ball just a little bit longer and deliver it with some confidence.
2nd and 10, ball on the 12-yard line. Colorado sets up in the eye. He passes it. Number 24 with a catch. Gain of 2. Drop back to pass. Number 1 is going to be sacked for a loss. They're stopped 2 yards behind the line. Number 3 takes a timeout.
So they're going to take their first field of the game.
Yard line. 4th down and 10. This should be an easy field goal. He gets it up.
Yeah, it's good.
And it sails through the uprights.
Turning the ball over.
Why not give it a shot?
19-yard line. The Ducks. And that was split back. Number 3 drops back. He's going long. Number 84 drops it. Guys, he threw that one right into the cover.
Kirk, nothing gets the coach more fired up than to throw a ball into coverage. Oh, wait. You never made mistakes like that, did you?
No, of course not. The Ducks line up in an eye formation. Back to throw. Now he's scrambling. He's a long one down the middle.
Well, that's right to it. I don't know why. I don't know how that happened. Oh, that's in the first half.
for the first half of play. Our halftime score, Oregon 14, Colorado 3.
Well, it's like, well, it's a game still. Even though I'm up by two touchdowns. Well, actually, by...
Colorado will be kicking off.
They're by, well, 11. So it's kind of like two touchdowns in ways. All right. Here we go. Oh, he muffed it.
Takes it for the six.
Crap.
And he couldn't get a thing going with that return, Lee Corso.
Brad, let me tell you something about kickoff returns. They require good blocking and precise timing. They didn't have either one of those things right there.
The Buffaloes come out in a 4-3.
All right, got first down. A little bit more.
And they make the stop.
Just don't fumble it.
Well, they picked up some good yardage on that run before they could bring it down.
Brad, that was a sensational run right there. This kid is very good.
It's first and 10, ball on the 22.
We're in the defense here. So.
The Buffaloes use a four-man throw here. He scrambled. He fires right.
Oh, he had it.
Knocks it away.
Shoot.
Man, he had to get rid of that ball in a hurry.
You know, it seems like he's allowing the defense right now to control him by throwing bad passes under pressure. What he needs to do is make some plays and start controlling the defense instead.
The Buffalo line up at a 4-3. He dropped back. He's going to try and scramble. He throws it.
Oh, again, same result.
Man, he had to get rid of that ball in a hurry.
Well, it seems like he's allowing the defense right now to control him by throwing bad passes under pressure. What he needs to do is make some plays and start controlling the defense instead.
The Buffaloes line up with six defensive backs. Drop back to pass.
Got it.
Number 15.
Oh, and I'm gone. Possibly, nope, but I made good yards out of it.
It's a 23-yard line. That ball was thrown high.
Yeah, but this receiver knew he could jump up and get it. Great play.
That was a lucky one, too. I kind of, well, actually, I broke a tackle, too. See, right there. If it was for that one guy who did get me, I'd been gone.
I'm telling my quarterback in this situation to look at the defense and audible to a better play if he has to.
Oh, crud.
Number 56 brings him down for a loss. And he was tackled short of the line of scrimmage.
Well, I'll tell you what, here the offensive line's got to do a better job. It looks like the running back was looking for some protection, and Lee, his lineman didn't provide any.
Hey, Kirk, they did the exact opposite. It was like a Spanish matador letting the bull charge.
Drops the throw.
Got it.
Wait, knocked out of bounds at the 22. He jumped up and snagged that ball.
Well, the quarterback threw the ball too high. Credit his receiver for going up to make the play.
Ball to 22. Third and 8. The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Drop back to pass. He passes it.
Touchdown.
It's caught, and it's caught for the touchdown.
That was a nice pass. A nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
He could have dropped it, too. It was real close.
Oregon to kick this one off. Number 14 and number 5 need to return. He kicks it. Number 5 fields it in the end zone. First and 10, ball on the 14-yard line.
All
Defense lines up in a 3-4. He drops back. Lets it go. Number 8.
Caught it.
Hangs on to it. Missed tackle.
Oh, fumble. That's mine.
They work hard and they got the turnover.
Well, this is what it's all about. Defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
Now everything's just falling apart for Colorado right now. Yep, that was fumble.
You gotta take what the defense gives you here.
Ball on the 32-yard line. First and 10. Oregon goes with the ace set here. Number 6 brings it.
Ain't another good run.
24-yard line. He had a really nice gain on that run.
Brad, I'm going to tell you, I think the defense needs to make some adjustments. Maybe move 8 or 9 guys into the box lead. Maybe they can slow down this running game.
You're right, Kirk. That guy could run through those holes.
The Ducks go with the I formation. Number 3 drops to throw. Guns it across the middle. Complete. Number 26 with a takedown at the 11. What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
They call it the red zone when you're inside the opponent's 20-yard line.
Ball on the 11-yard line. Number 9 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. Drops back and pass. Lets it fly. And it's gone.
Again.
Number 31 brings him down at the 6. Nice little pattern there.
Yeah, he had great position there. And that ball was thrown in the right spot. You just got to make sure that you're gaining positive yardage on a run because you're almost there.
They're grounding that line of scrimmage. Number 30 with a takedown at the 4. 1 yard on the play.
I like spreading the defense and throwing the ball in a goal line situation just like this.
They're crowding the line.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. That was a nice little touchdown run there, Coach.
Yeah, Brad. Well, they touched
just like the real game here. Blowing Colorado out. Ooh, that was almost a face mask, too.
And he tacks on the extra point.
I don't know why I say that when that tune is played. I don't know.
Number 25 kicks it off.
Touchback.
Number 14 fields it in the end zone. The Ducks line up with a three-man front. He unloads it. Complete. And he's taken down at the 27. And they were stopped for a minimal gain on the play.
That was a sensational effort by the defense. They were all over that pass.
We get third and 3 here. They line up in the jumbo set. Back to throw. Now he's scrambling. He passes it, and they couldn't hook up on that one.
Held him again.
Ball on the 27. Fourth down and 3. number 15, the return man. He gets it off. And down he goes.
Oh, no. Shoot. Butterfingers.
22, scoops up the loose ball. First and 10, ball on the 36-yard line.
That's all right. I don't like a turnover like that to happen.
Lines up to 3-4. Let's it fly. Brought down at the 31. Will it pick up to you with a pass play, Coach?
Yeah, it was. I like plays like these. As long as you're moving forward and not backward, you're doing pretty good.
Ball on the 31-yard line. Number 27 lines up in a deep back. Eye formation. He drops back. Let's it go. That's a loss of about 5.
And he ran out of bounds.
Ball on the 36-yard line. It's third down at 10. Number one is back in the gun. Back to throw. He's scrambling.
Number
30 comes away with a sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
Ball on the 41. Number 15, back to return it.
Nope, held him again.
Number 8 gets it off.
Touchback.
As a coach, you got to be concerned with what the defense is throwing at you. I tell my quarterback to take what the defense is giving you.
Colorado lines up defensively in a 4-3. And he's tackled at the 24. A pickup of about 3 yards.
I'll let the quarter run out.
And that'll bring this quarter to an end. Folks, we've played 3, and our score is Oregon 28, Colorado 3. And we're ready for the start of the fourth quarter. Ball on the 24-yard line. 2nd and 6 coming up here.
7.
4-man front by the defense. It's a blitz. And they make
big run there.
40-yard line. Nice pickup on that one.
Boy, it always helps when you're running behind a bunch of big daddies like these guys. I'd use some motion here and try to confuse the defense.
Ball on their own 40. 1st and 10. Number 9 lines up as a single back. Drops to throw. He passes it.
Complete. Got it again. Still going.
Tackle at the 38. And they get the first down on that completion, Coach.
That was a very nice first down conversion. The key to that play was the fact that the quarterback had plenty of time to look downfield. In this situation, I want my quarterback to be comfortable enough with the offense to be able to audible out of the play we call.
The Ducks come out of the ace formation. Here comes the defense. And they make the stop at the 41.
The defensive line was just too overpowering and didn't give the running back much of a chance there. A team that can run the ball has the best chance of winning. So I try to establish the run here.
4-man front by the defense. Number 12 brings it down at the 36-yard line. About 4 yards on that play.
I keep it on the ground and try to run the clock out here.
3rd and 8, ball on the 36.
I'm not playing time to run the clock.
The Ducks line up in a split back set. Smash and pass. Fires across the middle.
Oh, almost.
And he did a nice job.
Had his hands on it.
Well, he did a great job here of not risking a big gain. Instead, he just batted it down.
4th and 8 come up now. Ball on the
I don't think I'm going to make it, but I'll give it a shot. I'm up by big margin anyways.
I'm not sure he's got the power to make this one.
Oh, man.
He gets it up.
Nope, not enough.
And this one doesn't have the distance. First and 10, ball on their own 36. Three-man front defensively. Drops back to pass. Let's it go. And it's incomplete. And he couldn't hang out of that ball.
Well, that's frustrating for the quarterback right there because he threw the ball very well. You have to expect your receivers to make that kind of catch.
Second and 10, ball on the 36. Colorado lines up for the shotgun set. Drops back. Brought down at the 34. 2 yard loss.
Number 16. Loss of 2 yards on the play.
Ball on their own 34. Colorado comes out with an I formation.
We'll get it.
Number 33 with a takedown at the 32. Taken back a yard. Ball on the 32. Number 15 awaiting the return. Number 8 gets it off. Number 15 takes it at the 23. And down he goes at the 32-yard line. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Brad, with so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
Ball on their own 32. It's first and 10. They line up in an eye. Number 30 brings it down at the 38. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
I'd keep it on the ground and try to run the clock out here.
Second and 3 coming up, ball on the 38. Defense lines up in a 4-3. Here comes the defense.
Big opening there. Now they've probably been gone with the running back.
That was a nice run. Kirk, that was a good job by that big offensive line.
No, it really was, Brad. It was also a nice read by the ball carrier to find that running lane.
Ball on the 49-yard line. The Ducks line up in a goal line formation. Number 3 running the option. And he's tackled at the 44. They had a tough time bringing him down.
Well, he's running really hard right now, Brad. But how about the offensive line? They have their heads on a swivel.
Okay.
And they're looking
at anyone
clock. Down their path.
Usually I like to run it down in under 2 minutes. Well, what a good start. First half, overtime game with USC. Dominated the Cardinal and also dominated the Buffaloes.
What I would do here is to give the fullback the ball and just let him boom straight up.
So a great start off game, and now this. So what's going to be in line for the next game? We'll wait and see. It's the only thing. Oh. Delay game.
Delay of the game.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Loss of 5 yards.
I'd call a play like this to make sure that.
Sorry about that. I should pay attention to us.
That this kid's going to run out of bounds and stop the clock.
I was watching that clock.
Number 97 brings him down at the 38. They gained 5 yards there.
I'd call a play like this to make sure that there's no chance that this kid's going to run out of bounds and stop the clock.
Oregon sets up in the eye. Brought down at the 35. They get 3 yards on the play.
You gotta play it safe here and keep running the football.
Ball on the 35-yard line. Third and 5 coming up. The Ducks line up in an I formation. They win it. Tackle at the 29.
I'll end it.
That's the end of the game with a final score, Oregon 28-3.
And this one's all wrapped up. Coach, what's your final thought on the game?
I really didn't expect this one to be such a blowout, but that's exactly what we got. Oregon played an outstanding game out there. They looked very sharp from the get-go. Continue to pour it out till the final whistle.
Folks, thanks for spending your time with us in another game of NCAA Football 2002. We look forward to bringing you more great college football action in the future. Again, our final score, Oregon 28, Colorado 3. We hope you enjoyed this game as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. So long, everyone.
Okay, guys, up next will be more NASCAR 2005, Chase for the Cup, back to the top mode, my last month in the Truck Series, and I'll be moving on to the Grand National Series, and then the next college football game will be NCAA Football 2003. I'll be back with those.